بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم يا ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك بسم الله. This is a continuation of our series of Tafsir juzʼ 30. Today inshallah we will be talking about Surah al-Infitar and Surah al-Mutafifeen. So we've seen so far that juzʼ 30 is talking about the hereafter, the day after, the day of judgment. It's increasing the iman and the faith of the people of the new Muslim people who became Muslims in Mecca. So this juzʼ is almost all Mecca has Mecca surahs. So the surahs in juzʼ 30 are almost all were revealed in Mecca before the migration of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to Medina. So we start inshallah today with Surah Al-Infitar. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. This surah and Surah Al-Takwir resemble each other. The surah before that we talked about last week, they resemble each other in their subject matter. So they both talk about the hereafter and the signs, the images that we will be seeing in the day after. So Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we mentioned that he said, من سره أن ينظر إلى يوم القيامة كأنه رأي عين فليقرأ إذا الشمس كورت إذا السماء انشقت وإذا السماء انفطرت. Whoever wants to have a clear vision of the day of يوم القيامة, let him read Surah Al-Takwir, Surah Al-Inshiqaq, and Surah Al-Infitar. إذا السماء انفطرت. So now we're starting with the images that come at the beginning of this surah, and we will know why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has done this. Why did he bring the images at the beginning? What's the relation between these images and what will come after? إِذَا السَّمَاءُ انْفَطَرَتْ, when the heaven is cleft asunder, when the heaven is split, when the sky breaks apart, وَإِذَا الْكَوَاكِبُ انْتَثَرَتْ, and when the stars are scattered, they fall, when they leave their orbits, what will happen? Imagine a star now falling from its orbit. What will happen? Disasters. وَإِذَا الْبِحَارُ فُجِّرَتْ, and the oceans are torn apart. So the seas are erupted. And when the seas are all connected into one sea, this is what will happen. So they are connected because there are no more mountains, no nothing to separate them from each other. Now we have water is formed of hydrogen and oxygen. In the day after, when it will be Yawm al-Qiyamah, there won't be any hydrogen and oxygen combined together. They will separate. One is flammable. One will help to flame. So there will be a huge fire. وَإِذَا الْقُبُورُ بُعْثِرَتْ, and when the graves are laid open, when they are turned upside down, and this implies the resurrection of the dead. So those who are in the graves will come out. And what will happen to them? عَلِمَتْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ وَأَخَّرَتْ, each and every soul will know what they have sent forward and what they left behind. Everything will be presented before a person, so he will know that this is reality. All the deeds will be presented. Nothing will be hidden. They will know exactly what they did, whether it was good or evil. So now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us in these five ayahs the certain images of what's going to happen. What's the question that comes after it? Ya ayyuha al-insanu ma gharraka bi rabbika al-kareem. Oh man, what has deceived you and turned you away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the bountiful, the most merciful, the most generous? What made you careless about your Lord? This is actually a threat. It's a warning. It's not a question. It's not an attempt to get a reply. So why did you disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And the first thing at that moment that would come to man, it will be shaitan. And this would relate us to the point that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala outcasted shaitan from the heavens, he swore that he will do his whispering. He will keep whispering to the people of Adam, to the sons of Adam, to people, to man, so that he would go astray. And he said, لَأُضَلَّنَّهُمْ وَلَأُمَنِّيَنَّهُمْ. I will make them go astray. I will make them follow their desires. So why? Why you, man, did not follow? What happened to you? You did not follow the orders of Allah. الَّذِي خَلَقَكَ فَسَوَّاكَ فَعَدَلَكَ. Allah who created you, he fashioned you perfectly and gave you due proportion. He made you complete. He didn't make you walk on four or crawl, which is of the generosity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He made you complete. He made you straight. He perfectly balanced and proportioned in stature. Everything in you is well created. He fashioned you in the best form and shape that's suitable for you. في أي صورة ما شاء ركبك. In whatever form he willed, he put you together. So how do you look like? Do you look like your father, mother, paternal uncle, maternal aunt? He formed you in the way he wanted to, the best way for you. كلا بل تكذبون بالدين. No, this no is an emphasis that you shouldn't have done that. You shouldn't have been deceived. بل تكذبون بالدين. What make you disobey Allah is that you reject or you deny the day after, the day of judgment. You deny the recompense and the reckoning. So it's rejecting and not preparing someone and not preparing to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كَلَّا بَلْ تُكَذِّبُونَ بِالدِّينِ وَإِنَّ عَلَيْكُمْ لَحَافِظِينَ كِرَامًا كَاتِبِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ مَا تَفْعَلُونَ. And indeed, watchers have been appointed over you. So nothing is hidden from those watchers, from those angels. They are honestly kiram and katibin. They are honestly recording your deeds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they know, ya'lamuna ma taf'alun. They know exactly whatever you do, whether in private or in public. They know everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in one of the hadith al-Qudsi, إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَتَبَ الْحَسَنَاتِ وَالسَّيِّئَاتِ ثُمَّ بَيَّنَ ذَلِكَ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had something that's called good deeds, something that's called bad deeds, and he explained that. He sent messengers to explain what's good, what's bad, and to encourage good and to warn from bad. So, فَمَنْ هَمَّ بِحَسَنَةٍ وَلَمْ يَفْعَلْهَا كَتَبَهَ اللَّهُ عِنْدَهُ حَسَنَةٍ كَامِلَةٍ. Whoever intends to do something good, but he couldn't, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would register it as a complete hasana, as a complete good deed. And woman وَإِنْ هَمَّ بِهَا فَعَمِلَهَا كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ عِنْدَهُ عَشْرَ حَسَنَاتِ إِلَى سَبْعِمِائَةِ ضَعْفٍ إِلَى ضَعْفٍ كَثِيرٍ. And if he had the intention to do something good and he does it, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would write it in as 10 deeds, 10 good deeds, or that will be multiplied to 700 deeds or to much more. So this is the good deed. وَإِنْ هَمَّ بِسَيِّئَةٍ فَلَمْ يَعْمَلْهَا. But if he intended to do something bad, something evil, but did not do it, كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ لَهُ حَسَنَةً كَامِلًا. Look at the generosity of Allah. Allah will get it down for him as a full good deed. وَإِنْ هَمَّ بِهَا فَعَمِلَهَا كَتَبَهَا لَهُ سَيِّئَةً وَاحِدًا. And if he intended to do something bad and he did it, then it will be written for him as one bad deed. Look at the generosity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he will reward the good deeds with multiplied rewards, and he would write the bad deed as just one bad deed. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that in several ayahs, that مَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَى وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَى. If you do anything bad, anything as a speck size, if it's good, you will be rewarded. If it's bad, it will be written for you. إِنَّمَا هِيَ أَعْمَالُكُمْ أُحْصِيهَا لَكُمْ فَمَنْ وَجَدَ خَيْرًا فَلْيَحْمَدِ اللَّهِ وَمَنْ وَجَدَ غَيْرُ ذَلِكَ فَلَا يَذُمَنَّ إِلَّا نَفْسَهُ. There are noble guardians, angels over you who are writing everything. If you find something good, then you should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you find it other than this, you should blame yourself. So, kiraman katibin. These angels who are writing, they write everything. In Surah Al-Kahf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا وَيْلَنَا مَا لِهَذَا الْكِتَابِ لَا يُغَادِرُ صَغِيرَةً وَلَا كَبِيرَةً إِلَّا أَحْصَاهَا. Whoa, what sort of a book it is? It has left nothing unrecorded of our deeds, whether it's small or great, good or bad. So now we have everything recorded. We have two groups, winners and losers. Let's see what's going on. إِنَّ الْأَبْرَارَ لَفِي نَعِيمٍ. Verily, the righteous people are in delight. They are in pleasure. So who are the righteous? What is al-birr? Who are al-abrar? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Baqarah, ليس البر أن تولوا وجوهكم قبل المشرق والمغرب. So البر is not just to perform the ibadah, praying, doing, no. ولكن البر من آمن بالله. So it's not just doing the forms of ibadah, no. من آمن بالله, believe in Allah, واليوم الآخر, the day of judgment, الملائكة, angels, والكتاب, the Quran, والنبيين, the prophets, وَآتَ الْمَالَ عَلَىٰ حُبِّهِ ذَوِي الْقُرْبَىٰ. So to give wealth in spite of the love for it to ذَوِي الْقُرْبَىٰ, the relatives, الْيَتَامَ, the orphans, وَالْمَسَاكِينَ, the needy, وَابْنَ السَّبِيلِ, the traveler who needs some help. He doesn't have anyone to help him. وَالسَّائِلِينَ, and those who ask for help. وَفِي الرِّقَابِ, for freeing slaves. وَأَقَامَ الصَّلَاةِ, performed the prayers. Not only prayed, remember this. It's not pray, it's perform the prayer. So it's not just doing the movements of the prayer. No, we are present in the prayer. وَأَقَامَ الصَّلَاةَ وَآتَ الزَّكَاةِ, given zakah. وَالْمُوفُونَ بِعَهْدِهِمْ إِذَا عَاهَدُوا, they fulfill the promise if they promise. وَالصَّابِرِينَ, those who are patient during fil ba'sa, in poverty, wad-dara, and in hardship, wa hin al-ba's, during the battles. Ulaika alladhina sadaqu wa ulaika humul muttaqun. Those are the righteous people. So those are al-abrar, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says the righteous people are in delight. إِنَّ الْأَبْرَارَ لَفِي نَعِيمٍ. So what is the best of the na'im in the day after? It's to look at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to have the gaze of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This would be the highest joy in the day of judgment. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with those abrar, and they are pleased with him. So this is the first group. وَإِنَّ الْفُجَّارَ لَفِي جَحِيمٍ. And verily, the wicked will be in blazing fire, will be in hellfire. The evildoers will be in hell and in eternal torment. Those are the worst of creatures who wronged themselves. So they deserved the severe punishment of the day of judgment. What will happen to them? They are in the blazing fire, لَفِي جَحِيمٍ يَصْلَوْنَهَا يَوْمَ الدِّينِ. They shall be there, they shall enter it on the day of judgment, and they will taste its burning flame. They will suffer the consequences of their deeds and evil actions that they were doing, and they did not care about the day of judgment and the punishment there. وَمَا هُمْ عَنْهَا بِغَائِبِينَ. They shall never be absent from it. Even 1 hour of torment, they would wish that this punishment would be reduced. No. They would wish that they would get some rest from the punishment. No. They would wish they will die from and to end this punishment. No. كلما أرادوا أن يخرجوا منها أعيدوا فيها. Every time they wish to emerge from it, they will be returned to it. It will be eternal torment for them. وما أدراك ما يوم الدين. And what do you know of the day of judgment? Why they did not pay attention? ثم ما أدراك ما يوم الدين. Again, it's an emphasis. What do you know of the day of judgment? So why did you, man, take it easy during your life and you did not care? It's a threat. It will be a great day. What will happen on that day? يوم لا تملك نفس لنفس شيئا والأمر يومئذ لله. On that day when no one can benefit anyone else. No soul is responsible for another soul. And the command that day will be to Allah and Allah only. So Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, يا بني هاشم أنقذوا أنفسكم من النار لا أملك لكم من الله شيئا. O children of Hashim, save yourselves from the fire, for I have no power to cause you any benefits from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He even told his own daughter, يا فاطمة اعملي فلا أغني عنك من الله شيئا. It's the day when no one shall have the power to do anything for another one, unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills that this thing will happen. And on that day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask, لِمَنِ الْمُلْكُ الْيَوْمِ لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَارِ. There is no one to answer except him. Whose is this, is the kingdom this day? Whose is the kingdom this day? It's Allah's. The one, the irresistible. He's the owner of the day of judgment. Nothing will happen except what he wills. So the whole surah is just convincing or instilling in the mind and in the heart the importance of the day after. Now, inshallah, we will move to another surah with a little bit of a shift at the beginning of the surah. So the surah, Surah al-Mutafifeen, starts with something that was widespread at the time of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam? What was it? So people would go short in weighing for people, and they would ask, they would command for full measures if someone is weighing for them. So when they want to receive their due from others, they demand it. It should be given to them in full. But when they measure for other people, they would give less than what was due. And one of the people at the time of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he used to have two measures. If he wants to weigh for people, he would use one of them. If someone will weigh for him, he will use the other one, the accurate one. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this surah. وَيْلٌ لِلْمُطَفِّفِينَ. So it's a big threat. It's destruction. It's a big threat. Woe to those who give short weight and who take full weight from others. So they skimmed only small amounts, not substantial amounts from what is due to others, but this happens always. الَّذِينَ إِذَا اكْتَالُوا عَلَى النَّاسِ يَسْتَوْفُونَ. They demand to receive their full measures, their dues, in full from others. And sometimes they would ask for extra as well. وَإِذَا كَالُوهُمْ أَوْ وَزَنُوهُمْ يُخْسِرُونَ. And when they have to give measures or to give weight to others, they will give less than due. They would decrease the amount or the money or whatever to that they will be giving. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about this thing in several surahs. In Surah Al-Isra, he says, وَأَوْفُوا الْكَيْلَ إِذَا زِنْتُمْ وَزِنُوا بِالْقِسْطَاسِ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ ذَلِكَ خَيْرٌ وَأَحْسَنُ تَأْوِيلًا. And give full measure when you measure, and weigh with a balance that is straight. That's good and better for you at the end. Again, in Surah Al-Rahman, he says, وَأَقِيمُوا الْوَزْنَ بِالْقِسْطِ وَلَا تُخْسِرُوا الْمِيزَانِ. And observe the weight with equity, and do not make balance deficient. Well, let's stop here and think about one important issue. Does this mean only to be fair in weighing and measures and scale? No. This issue covers everything. It covers the husband who asks for full rights, whereas he doesn't give his wife her full rights. It also covers the one who goes to work. He doesn't fulfill his duty, but at the end of the month, he gets all his salary in full. It's about the father who does not fulfill his duties to his children, and he asks them for full respect. Well, it's about the wife who does not do her best, who does not do her duties towards her husband, her children, her in-laws, or her everything that's related to her life as a wife, and she always asks for her full duty, her full rights. There should be balance. أَلَا يَظُنُّ أُولَٰئِكَ أَنَّهُمْ مَبْعُوثُونَ لِيَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. Do they not think that they will be resurrected on a great day? Do they not fear this resurrection and standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who knows everything? There will be great horror on that day. There will be great fear on that day. يَوْمَ يَقُومُ النَّاسُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. So people on that day will all stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Rabbil Alameen, the Lord of all that exists. They will be held accountable for their deeds. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam emphasized that everyone is going to be there. يقول يوم يقوم الناس لرب العالمين حتى يغيب أحدهم في رشحه إلى أنصاف أذني. This will be the day that mankind will all stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until one of them will sink up to the middle of his ears in sweat. يكونون في العرق كقدر أعمالهم فمنهم من يأخذه إلى عقبيه ومنهم من يأخذه إلى ركبتيه ومنهم من يأخذه إلى حقويه ومنهم من يلجمه الجامع. They will be submersed in sweat based on their deeds. There will be those whose sweat will come up to their heels, others to their knees, others to their waists, others to their necks. They will be brittled in sweat. So we mentioned in the previous surah, Surah al-Infitar, which we just covered, that the angels are writing the deeds. This surah, Surah al-Mutafifeen, will talk about the books that the angels have written, the records that have been written. كَلَّا إِنَّ كِتَابَ الْفُجَّارِ لَفِي سِجِّينَ. Nay, truly, the record of the wicked people, the record of the evildoers is preserved in Sijjin. Okay, what is Sijjin? Sijjin, يقول رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, يقول الله عز وجل في روح الكافر, اكتبوا كتابه في سجين وسجين هي تحت الأرض السابعة. So Allah says concerning the souls of the non-believers, record his book in سجين. And سجين is beneath the seventh earth. It's the lowest of the low. So where is the record of the wicked people, of the evildoer people? In the lowest of the low. So what is Sijjin? Kitabun marqum. What is this book? It's a book written complete and preserved. No one can add or to it or remove from it anything. No one can edit anything in that book. Waylu yawma'idhin lilmukadhibin. Whoa, that day to those who deny. Disgraceful torment that day to those who denied. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا عِلِّيُّونَ. So what will happen? Who are those who disbelieved? Who are those? وَيْلُ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلْمُكَذِّبِينَ الَّذِينَ يُكَذِّبُونَ بِيَوْمِ الدِّينِ. So those who deny the day of recompense. They do not believe it will happen. So Allah is threatening those people. Who are those? وَمَا يُكَذِّبُ بِهِ إِلَّا كُلُّ مُعْتَدٍ أَثِيمٍ. And none can deny it except every transgressor, every sinner. Doing what's forbidden. Exceeding the limits. When acquiring the permissible also. إِذَا تُتْلَى عَلَيْهِ آيَاتُنَا قَالَ أَسَاطِيرُ الْأَوَّلِينَ. So when our revelations are recited to him, he says, oh, wait, these are tales of the ancient times. These are tales of the legends of the former people. So he would deny that these are, this Quran is by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They would think that Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reciting something that has been said to him or something that has been given to him as stories of the previous people, of the previous nations, of the previous prophets. كلا بل ران على قلوبهم ما كانوا يكسبون. Nay, but what they have earned has stained their hearts. So, what's going on? Now, asatir al-awwaleen, the Qur'an is the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the only thing that blocked their heart from believing in it, that they would say asatir al-awwaleen about it, is that it is the dark covering that overcome their hearts because of their sins. Let's understand this in a way. Take a white page, and if there is a sin, then just put a black dot, another black dot, another black dot for sins. So if someone does not repent, the whole page will be filled up with black dots, and the whole page will be a cover on the heart. So the only way to erase these black dots is to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to do istighfar, to promise Allah that the bad thing will not happen again. So this istighfar, this asking for forgiveness would be as an eraser to erase these black dots. Otherwise, the heart will be covered with a veil of blackness. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِنَّ الْعَبْدَ إِذَا أَذْنَبَ كَانَتْ نُكْتَةً سَوْدَاءَ فِي قَلْبِهِ فَإِنْ تَابَ مِنْهَا سَقُلَ قَلْبُهُ. So the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if he commits a sin, then there will be a black spot. A black spot will appear on his heart. So if he repents and asks for forgiveness, then his heart will be polished again. وَإِنْ زَادَ, but if he increased in sinning, زَادَتْ. These spots continue to increase. فَذَلِكَ قَوْلُ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى. So this explains the ayahs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كَلَّا بَلْرَانَ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ مَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. So الران covers the heart of the non-believers. كَلَّا إِنَّهُمْ عَنْ رَبِّهِمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ لَمَحْجُوبُونَ. And again, when we mention a story of the previous prophets, when we mention a story about certain nation, we take the wisdom of that story. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying there will be a cover on the hearts of the sinners, then we have to be aware that the saying astaghfirullah, giving sin, this will be as an eraser and as a polish to the heart. كَلَّا إِنَّهُمْ عَنْ رَبِّهِمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ لَمَحْجُوبُونَ. Nay, they are on that day veiled from seeing their Lord. And this by itself is the worst of the punishment. So they will not see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as the righteous people would see him. So they veiled themselves from worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in dunya, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala veiled them, kept them away. ثُمَّ إِنَّهُمْ لَصَالُوا الْجَحِيمِ. Then verily, they will indeed enter the burning flame of hell. They will not see Allah, and they will be with the people of fire. إِنَّهُمْ لَصَالُوا الْجَحِيمِ. ثُمَّ يُقَالُ هَذَا الَّذِي كُنْتُمْ بِهِ تُكَذِّبُونَ. Then it will be said to them that this is what you used to deny. It will be said to them in a way of scolding, on a way of belittling, humiliating those who denied the day after. So this is the status of the non-believers, where their book is and how they are tortured. Now the other part is kalla inna kitab al-abrari lafi 'illiyyin. Hey, verily the record of the righteous believers is preserved in a place of highness. It's the highest of the high. Where that, though the other ones were in the lowest of the low, but the abrar, the righteous, the believers are in the highest of the high. Their record is preserved in highness. So it is the seventh heaven, and it contains the souls of the believers. So Allahumma ja'alna fi a'la 'illiyin, ya Allah, we ask you to consider us with those whom you are pleased with them, ya arhamar rahimin. Now, wama adraka ma 'illiyun? And what do you know of that place, 'illiyun? What is 'illiyun? 'Illiyun is the highest place that the record of the abrar, of the believers, of the winners, is kept in that area. So it's honoring the righteous. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا عِلِّيُّونَ. Yes. كِتَابٌ مَرْقُومٌ يَشْهَدُهُ الْمُقَرَّبُونَ. It's a written book, complete and preserved. It's guarded and witnessed by the angels nearest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala moves on to talk about the place of al-abrar. So he says, إِنَّ الْأَبْرَارَ لَفِي نَعِيمٌ. Verily, the righteous believers will be in delight. So what are they going to see? What are they going to witness? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَعْدَدْتُ لِعِبَادِيَ الصَّالِحِينَ مَا لَا عَيْنٌ رَأَتْ وَلَا أُذُنٌ سَمِعَتْ وَلَا خَطَرَ عَلَى قَلْبِ بَشَرٍ. I have prepared for my righteous slaves that which no eye has seen, no ear has heard, and has never crossed the mind of any human being. They will be in eternal pleasure in gardens that contain comprehensive bounties. عَلَى الْأَرَائِكِ يَنْظُرُونَ. They will be seated on high couches looking around. They are watching and enjoying the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. تَعْرِفُ فِي وُجُوهِهِمْ نَضْرَةَ النَّعِيمِ. So you recognize the brightness of delight in their faces. You notice a glow of delight in their faces when you look at them. They are happy, they are laughing, they are experiencing, happy with the great, with great delight. They are happy with what Allah has prepared for them. وَجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ مُسْفِرَةٌ ضَاحِكَةٌ مُسْتَبْشِرَةٌ. So some faces on the day of judgment, what about them? Some faces will be reflecting light. They will be bright. They'll be laughing. They'll be rejoicing at the good news. They will be celebrating. And those are the people of paradise. يُسْقَوْنَ مِنْ رَحِيقٍ مَخْتُومٍ خِتَامُهُ مِسْكٍ. So they will be given to drink of pure sealed wine, whose seal shall be misk. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Muhammad says, مَثَّلُ الْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي وَعِدَ الْمُتَّقُونَ فِيهَا أَنْهَارٌ مِّن مَّاءٍ غَيْرِ آسٍ وَأَنْهَارٌ مِّن لَّبَنٍ لَّمْ يَتَغَيَّرْ طَعْمُهُ وَأَنْهَارٌ مِّن خَمْرٍ لَّذَّةٍ لِّلشَّارِبِينَ. The righteous people, the winners, will have rivers of a lot of things. One of them is rivers of wine, delicious to those who drink. وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ. For this reward, for this situation, for these bounties, let the competitors compete. Let them strive to gain more. So the companions of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when they used to gather, when they would ask each other, how many khatmas have you read? How many juzʼ have you read? How many rak'ahs have you prayed? How long did you go for qiyam al-layl? How long did you do that? How much time did you spend with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How present were you in your prayer? For this, for the like of this, let the workers work. Let people encourage each other. Let them compete and strive to gain more. وَمِزَاجُهُ مِنْ تَسْنِيمٍ. So, يُسْقَوْنَ مِنْ رَحِيقٍ مَخْتُومٍ خِتَامُهُ مِسْكٍ وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ وَمِزَاجُهُ مِنْ تَسْنِيمٍ. So this wine which they will be offered is being described, it's mixed with tasneem. What is tasneem? عَيْنًا يَشْرَبُ بِهَا الْمُقَرَّبُونَ. Tasneem is a pure fountain that's coming down from height, which has the most excellent and exalted drink. It's a fountain. It's a fountain for those who are the nearest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ أَجْرَمُوا كَانُوا مِنَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا يَضْحَكُونَ. So verily, those wicked non-believers who committed bad deeds, evil deeds, used to laugh at those who believed. They used to laugh at the believers. They would mock them. They would humiliate them. وَإِذَا مَرُّوا بِهِمْ يَتَغَامَزُونَ. And whenever those non-believers passed the believers, they used to wink one to another. They mocked the believers with their eye gestures. وَإِذَا انْقَلَبُوا إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهِمُ انْقَلَبُوا فَكِهِينَ. And when they returned to their kinsfolks, so their own people, the non-believers, or whoever who are related to or of the same religion, they would return very happy, jesting. They would go back pleased and satisfied that they did something bad to the believers. They made fun of them. They would love to talk about what they have done to the believers. وَإِذَا رَأَوْهُمْ قَالُوا إِنَّ هَؤُلَاءِ لَضَالُّونَ. So if those non-believers saw the righteous, the believers, the good people, they would say, oh, verily they have gone astray. Because they have gone astray by not worshipping the idols and by not worshipping the gods, and because they left the religion of their fathers and forefathers. They abandoned this amazing religion. So why are they talking about them like this? Why are they mocking them? Why are they doing them? وَمَا أُرْسِلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ حَافِظِينَ. They were not sent as watchers or guardians over them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not appointed them as keepers over them, so they are not. So why are they criticizing them? These wrongdoers have not been made responsible for them. Why have they made them the focus of their attention? فَالْيَوْمَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنَ الْكُفَّارِ يَضْحَقُونَ. So what will happen on the day of judgment? Today, on the day of judgment, the believers are laughing at the non-believers. So they would say, you were laughing at us in dunya, but now it's our turn to laugh at you. فَالْيَوْمَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنَ الْكُفَّارِ يَضْحَكُونَ. So those who believed, they will be laughing. عَلَى الْأَرَائِكِ يَنْظُرُونَ. They recline on couches, watching, enjoying their reward in paradise. رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ. They are, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased of them, is pleased with them, and they are pleased with him. They are pleased with the great things, with the bounties, with the reward that they are living in. هَلْ ثُوِّبَ الْكُفَّارُ مَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ. Haven't the non-believers been duly rewarded what they used to do? Haven't they been recompensed for their mockery and belittling of the believers? They surely will be paid in full. So if If we have a general look at the surah, we find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has started this surah by talking about those who do bad in measurements, who go bad for measuring, whether real measuring or whether it's just the an image of the measuring. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to have a strong society and wants to have good believers who believe in the day after. And that's why he sent the messengers to explain to his servants what they will expect if they go, if they do good or if they do bad. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. يا ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك. إن شاء الله we'll go on next week. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.